Knowing that the tension in cable AB is 1425 newtons, determine the components of the force exerted on the plate at B. Here, this is the given figure and it is asked to calculate the components of force at point B. So here you have to consider equilibrium of point B. Why? Because it is asked to calculate the components of force at B. So when I consider equilibrium of point B, so it will be like this. So this is point B. It is having connection with another point A by means of a rope, right? So or string. Along the string, there will be tensile force. Tensile force means it will be away from the point, right? And in the question, it is mentioned that it is 1425 newtons. So here, finally, we have to calculate the force components at B, right? So in order to calculate force components, first you have to calculate the coordinates of these two points and later position vector and then unit vector. Finally, force vector you need to calculate. First, let us calculate the coordinates of these two points. In order to calculate the coordinates of these two points, first you have to observe where is the intersection of these three axes, x axis, y axis, z axis. So the intersection of these three axes is nothing but origin. So if you want to find the coordinates of any point, you have to reach that point by traveling along xyz axis or parallel to xyz axis. So here I want to find coordinates of B. So I have to start from origin and without lifting my pen, so I have to reach point B, and remember I have to travel along xyz or parallel to xyz. So here I can reach point B when I travel along positive x direction, right? So here you may ask which is positive x, which is negative x. From the origin, if you travel in the given x direction, it is positive. In the opposite direction, it is negative. From the origin, if you travel in the given y direction, it is positive. In the opposite direction, that means vertically downwards, it is negative. From the origin, in the given z direction, it is positive. In the opposite direction, it is negative. So here, from origin to point B, I have traveled a distance of 900 along x direction. So x coordinate will be 900. Here, to reach this point, I didn't travel along y direction and z direction. So those two coordinates will be 0. Next, let us find the coordinates of A. In order to find the coordinates of A, I have to start from origin and I have to reach the point A. So I can travel along xyz axis or parallel to xyz axis. First, I will travel like this along y direction and parallel to z axis. I will travel like this. First, I have traveled from origin to this point, so to a distance of 600. This is 600, right? And this distance is 360. Here, I didn't travel along x direction, so x coordinate will be 0. And along y direction, I have traveled a 600 in the given y direction, so it is positive, so 600. And from origin, I have traveled a distance of 360 in this direction, parallel to z axis. So as I traveled in the given z direction, it is positive, so 360. So now we got the coordinates. So now we have to take the position vector. You may ask whether we have to take BA bar or AB bar. So if you observe the direction of tensile force here, it is directed from B to A. We considered equilibrium of point B, right? So it is directed from B to A. So we have to consider the position vector BA bar. So I am writing it here. So position vector BA bar is equal to OA bar minus OB bar. OA bar is nothing but this is 0 I bar plus 600 J bar plus 360 K bar. This is OA bar minus OB bar 900 I bar plus 0 J bar plus 0 k bar. So I will get position vector as 0 minus 900, so minus 900 I bar plus 600 minus 0, 600 j bar, 360 minus 0 plus 360 k bar. This is the position vector BA bar. For finding force components at a point, first you have to calculate position vector. Next, Let us calculate the magnitude of this position vector. Magnitude of position vector is nothing but modulus of VA bar. So that is square root of minus 900 whole square plus 600 square plus 360 square. So when I simplify this one, I will get 11140. So this is magnitude of this vector. So I have calculated position vector. Next, I will calculate unit vector. So unit vector is nothing but, you can denote that one with lambda BA bar. So that is nothing but magnitude of position vector divided by, magnitude of vector divided by its magnitude. So BA bar I know. So which is nothing but minus 900 I bar plus 600 J bar plus 360 K bar divided by 11140. So this is lambda BA bar unit vector. So finally, I need to find force vector F BA bar is equal to, it is nothing but the product of tensile force along BA, as it is along the string. I am denoting it here with S. You can use the letter T also. It is product of tensile force along BA multiplied by unit vector lambda BA bar. So from that, F BA bar is equal to, tensile force along BA is given in the question itself. It is 1425 newtons. So 1425 multiplied by unit vector. Just now we got minus 900 I bar plus 600 J bar plus 360 K bar divided by 11140. So first divide this one with 11140. You will get 1.25 into minus 900 I bar plus 600 J bar plus 360 K bar. So multiply each and every term with 1.25, then minus 1125 I bar plus 750 J bar plus 450 K bar. So this is the final force vector. What we require is nothing but force vector. So here it is in the form of F bar is equal to Fx I bar plus Fy J bar plus Fz K bar. Here the coefficient of I bar is nothing but the magnitude of force along x direction or the force component along x direction. So Fx is, you have to consider I bar coefficient here. So minus 1125 newtons. This is Fx. Now Fy is nothing but coefficient of J bar, which is nothing but 750 newtons. And coefficient of K bar, Fz is 450 newtons. Here first I have considered position vector, later unit vector, finally force vector. And after getting the force vector, so I have compared that one with this one. F bar is equal to Fx I bar plus Fy J bar plus Fz K bar. So then I got the components of force at point B. So which is nothing but Fx, Fy, Fz. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, click on like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching.